Welcome to Highway Caravan Centre. We're the number one dealer in Southeast Victoria for JB Caravans and Crusader Caravans. Offering comprehensive financing and great deals on trade-ins, our specialised technicians in our service department cover all your caravan needs from minor to major repairs, including competitive prices and great advice on your next escape. With over 40 new and used caravans in stock, stop by at 1975 Princes Highway, Nar Nar Goon for your next caravan adventure, because every journey begins on the highway.
G'day, it's Brendan again from Highway Caravan Centre. Today we're going to have a quick look at the Crusader Excalibur Castle in a family bunk. So what I'll do is I'll run around the outside of the van for you, show you some key features, and then we'll move into the inside of the van. So starting at the front, one thing I do like to mention about with the Crusaders, they've got a 450 MPa Australian made steel chassis, and it's 6 inches from your A-frame all the way through to your rear bar. Another nice little bit of finish here, you'll notice you've got the Excalibur trims on your drawbar here, just for a bit of protection. Stops those stone chips, etc. Connection-wise to the back of your vehicle, we've got our standard 50mm ball. Electrical-wise, we've got a Gray Anderson plug and a 12-pin flat. And then standard, which is standard with Australian safety standards, we have got our breakaway switch as well. Gas-wise, we've got 2 9-kilo bottles here at the front. Gives you plenty of gas to run your cooker, your fridge, etc. We also have a nice little freshwater tap here at the A-frame with a stone protector on the front of it. You'll notice too, there's quite a large toolbox here with jerry can holders either side. This TB07 toolbox has twin entry points, one either side, and on both sides of this toolbox there is a little slide here, again perfect for your gas barbecue. Reason being, you've got a little recessed gas bayonet just here, makes it nice and easy to hook your barbecue up to it. Okay, so further along we've got our tunnel boot. Now, the thing I love about Crusaders as well, they've got an extremely large tunnel boot. Perfect for things like blow mold tables, camping chairs, holding annexes if you choose to have an annex installed later on down the track. And there's also a nifty little bit of information here, which is your compliance plate, which will give you pretty much all the weights of your caravan. So a tear, looking at this one, I think is 2,812 kilos. With an ATM of 3,500 kilos, with a ball weight at loading, I think that's 180 kilo. Okay, close that up, and then moving further along, you'll notice too, we've got an 18-foot rollout awning here with a center support. Dometic double glazed windows throughout your van as well. We've got a nice little entertainment hatch here, so you've got all the things you need to hook up to your TV. So you've got your TV mounting bracket, power source, and aerial jack as well. While you're outside under your awning on a nice beautiful summer's day, we've also got a drop down picnic table, perfect for your cheese and nibblies, glass of wine, or a beer, whatever takes your fancy. Twin water resistant speakers externally as well. And we've got 3 bug lights just underneath your awning as well. Towards the back of the van here, you notice this little hatch here. This is basically, all it does is house your toilet cassette. So again, a very simple operation. You just lift that cassette out, wheel it to your dump point, try not to spill anything on yourself, and then empty it into the dump point at your caravan's day park. Okay, towards the back of the van, again, we've got a Safety Dave reversing camera with a live feed microphone in it. We've got high quality LED tail lights and your spare wheel mounted on your rear bar. Okay, so looking at the roadside of the van, we've got twin bunk windows here. Nice large bunk windows, so they're directly in line with your bunks at the back of the van. We also have twin 95 litre filler points for our fresh water tanks. Okay, one other thing I'll make mention too, this van has got a 95 litre grey water tank with a mains pressure flush out valve, so you can flush all that gunk out of the bottom of your grey water tank. Another nifty little feature that Crusader have done this year is they've decided to mount their Flowjet fully sealed water pump outside the van. So as you can see there, it's hiding behind a chassis rail on a steel plate. Further along, you'll notice there's a couple of vents here. So basically that's for your fridge. Helps to keep your fridge, the back of your fridge, nice and cold. We also have an external hot and cold shower. This here is our exhaust port for our gas electric hot water service. We also have a 120 amp hour deep cycle battery just under there. Couple that up with two 170 watt solar panels and free camping is a breeze. So suspension wise, we've got the Alco Enduro Tough Ride suspension, which basically is twin gas shocks and a coil spring per trailing arm. So just here, you'll notice there's a little black box here. This is for our 240 volt in when you're at a caravan park. And you also have, as a standard safety specification, we've got our safety switch here. There's also a little Explorer plug here, which basically means you can hook up to satellite dish or TV aerial at a caravan park. And then here is just basically the other side of our tunnel boot. So again, like I said, an extremely large tunnel boot that goes all the way through and checker plate lined. All right, so now I'm going to talk about the Camec tri-lock door. So basically this door has got a three locking position. So we've got one, two, three points to secure your door. It also, you can separate your door just by twisting the handle up like so. And then you've got your Amplimesh security fly screen there. Obviously gives you the opportunity to have plenty of flow through ventilation in your caravan. Okay, so inside this this lovely van, you'll notice seating wise we've got a club lounge with a mapper table leg. So basically this mapper table leg will pretty much move any which way you want it to, into any seating position that you so desire. And the other really good thing about it too is you can drop that table down, put a cushion on top of it and turn it into another small sleeping arrangement, or conversely use it as a day bed. At your seating too, you'll notice there's a couple of down lights here. Now these little reading down lights also feature USB points just underneath there. So every reading light that you've got in the van or little down light has got a USB port in it as well. Kitchen wise, as you can see here, we got plenty of bench space, plenty of room to do preparation for meals. We've got a stainless steel sink with a three-way flip mixer tap. So you've got your standard hot and cold water up here, and then down here you've got the filtered water function as well. Little touch lights as well, just above here, just to turn on and off so you can illuminate what you're doing. We've also got a range hood just above your grill here. So we've got basically a three gas burner hob with a 240 volt ring, a mini grill, and also an oven. Another thing that I like about Crusader with their cabinetry, you can also see that their piano hinge pretty much all the way through, just for added strength and durability. The microwave, in my personal opinion, is in a really good place. It's down low rather than being up high, so it doesn't become such a spilling hazard. And the other thing that I like about kitchen being on the curbside is it's nice and easy to pass meals out through your kitchen window, so you can sit out there under your awning and have a bit of a feed. Another thing that I like about this van is the kitchen is on the curbside. So you can easily, you know, cook up a couple of snags or do some cheese and bickies. Just open up your window, pass it out there. Hubby can pick it up, put it on the table. You're out under your awning, nice and easy. One thing too with the Dometic windows here, you'll notice we've got a couple of blinds. So we've got our block out blind here. And then on the other side, we've got our no-see-em micro mesh, mozzie mesh there. Plenty of double power points throughout this van. So we've got some in the kitchen there. So there's two power points. You'll find there'll be some power in the little cubby holes that I'll show you in a minute as well. Okay, so that's pretty much it for the living area of this little van, kitchen and seating wise. What I'll do next is run through the sleeping arrangement for you. So the main sleeping area for the adults here, you'll notice you've got a 6'2" caravan queen. It's got plenty of cabinetry either side of the bed too, so you've got a nice locker up here. Again, piano hinge throughout for extra strength and durability. And we've also got a hanging locker just here. We also have a nice front window at the bed end with a stone protector as well on that window. Also have a nice hatch up here with an LED light that you can turn on and off. It actually features a blockout blind as well. And on the other side, we've got the Mozzie mesh. Okay, standard feature in this van as well is twin Sirocco fans at your bed. And we also have a bit of storage underneath here. As you can see there, we've got an access drawer and then just a void there. Okay, so for the kids, we've got two bunks here. Good thing about the Crusader bunks, they're one of the largest bunks on the market. Another nice feature, like I said, you've got your down lights, your little LED reading lights there with the USB ports in there so they can charge their iPads or whatever it might be. Other standard features in this particular van is twin Sirocco fans at your bunks as well to help circulate the air to keep the kids cool. We also have plenty of storage underneath. We've got four drawers there, cabinetry up here. Behind this big cabinet here, we have got our front load washing machine as well, and then a little bit of cabinetry down the bottom there as well. One beautiful thing that I like about this particular van, you'll find that the kids' bunks are on the roadside as opposed to the curbside. So if you're outside entertaining with some friends, having a couple of drinks, whatever, the kids won't be sticking their heads out the window and watching what you're doing. Another thing that I like with this particular van is you've got this sliding door here. So basically you can close off your kid's sleeping area. So now looking at the ensuite here, as you can see, you've got a nice Dometic ceramic bowl toilet. We've got a couple of towel racks here. We've also got cabinetry just up here for things like spare towels, etc. I'll move around to the other side, excuse my back. We've also got our ceramic basin here with a flip mixer tap, and also cabinetry just under there as well. Nice large mirror, so you can look at yourself in the mirror. We've also got a double power point for things like electric razors and hair dryers. Shower-wise, Crusader are renowned for having one of the largest shower recesses on the market. Again, you can see you've got a nice large shower rose there, flip mixer tap, all in the stainless steel. We also have a couple little exhaust ports here, so they've got the ventilation fans with the LED lights around them to help extract the steam when you're having a piping hot shower. Okay, so one of the important parts of this van is the fridge. Obviously, if you've got kids, you're going to need to feed them. This is a nice large 188-litre three-way fridge. So as you can see there, it's got a large freezer compartment and a nice generous fridge storage area as well. So in this little cabinet here, there's a couple little things that I'll make mention of. So number one, we've got our battery management system, which houses all of our fuses. So if anything happens to go wrong, first port of call is to check your fuse array, just to make sure that you haven't blown any fuses. Then you've also got your hot water switches here, so you can toggle between gas or electric depending on where you are. If you're at a van park, just flicker onto electric and away you go. We also have a little dimmer switch here. So basically this dimmer switch will control the LED strip lighting just above your cabinetry there. You can turn it down or turn your disco lights up. And then we also house our NCE stereo / CD player / DVD player. Heating and cooling wise, we have a Dometic Ibis 4 soft start reverse cycle air conditioner. I hope this gives you a better insight into this feature packed van. Lovely family van, great for creating lots of memories and holidays with your kids. If you have any further inquiries or questions, don't hesitate to call the number below. And please, can you like and subscribe to our YouTube channel? That'd be much appreciated. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.